Ladies and gentlemen, we are at an epochal moment in Indian sport. It's pretty much like what happened in Indian cricket in the early 70s. Suddenly we started going abroad and we started winning matches. And similarly, in non-cricket sports in India, we've reached a point where event after event, we're winning medals. More important than that, we are in contention for medals day after day, every day. In cricket, 10 years after that epochal moment, we were world champions. And we ended up being one of the biggest countries that play cricket in the world. It's going to be a lot harder in Olympic sport because it's not restricted to 7-8 countries. But with us this afternoon, we have 3 trailblazers who are making it possible. So another round of applause, please, for Heena Sidhu, PV Sindhu, and Hima. Let me actually start by asking a question about that. And I'll start with you, Heena. Do you feel part of a revolution now? When you're at a multi, at a big event where news is coming in that other people are winning medals, your event is coming up. Do you feel that way?
Yes, of course. The times have changed. It's been 12 years now that I've been shooting, and the scene has changed, and I've seen it change with my own eyes. Like when I started shooting 12 years back, it was very different. It was tough to start a sport, to be a beginner in sport. It was hard. And even if you win, you never got the recognition. But now the times have changed, and it's not only the recognition that we get, but also the things have gotten very easy for the juniors, for the youngsters who want to take up a sport. We now have quality coaches, we now have quality infrastructure. So you see the revolution everywhere, and yes, we do feel a part of it.
Sindhu, you know, recently Rajyavardhan Rathore, who's now our sports minister, himself an Olympic medalist, wrote an article saying that there was a time when he would be waiting outside the sports ministry and he would see athletes sitting over there and just waiting for a chance to meet an official. Do you have to encounter anything like that any longer? Or have things moved beyond that point?
Well, definitely yes, because there have been a lot of changes compared to before. And now if you see, we've been getting like everything, the support from the government or the sponsors have been supporting us. Like, we are very thankful. Like, when I started playing, I didn't have any tough times, I can say, because I had all the support. And before, definitely there were like a lot of hard work they come from a very small thing. And now they are, you know, like, for example, Rajyavardhan Rathore, as you said. So I think I have to be very thankful in that way because there have been a lot of sponsors. But I think from now on, the change have been there. And I feel that it should start from the grassroots level, definitely. If it starts from the grassroots level, I think everything should be fine. Yeah.
Hima, jab aapne ghar pe bola ki sports khelna hai, to kya bola unhone? Unhone bola khelo ki unhone bola future kharab ho jayega?
मैं मेरा पापा भी एक फुटबॉल खिलाड़ी थी सो फैमिली ने बहुत सपोर्ट किया है खेल के लिए पापा हर बार बोलते हैं तू खेल के जाओ और पापा का इंस्पिरेशन से खेल में आया ऐसे
आपके साथ जो वहां पे हैं वो खेलते हैं कि पढ़ाई करते हैं
कौन
आपके साथ में सहेलियां जो आपका है
नहीं ऐसा ऐसे तो गांव में बहुत सारा टैलेंट है बट सुविधा नहीं मिलते है तो ऐसे गांव में खेलते हैं बट मैं खुद ही निकल के आ गया सो आज यहाँ पे पहुँच गया
और पहले आप फुटबॉल खेलते थे
हाँ
फिर रनिंग में कैसे पहुँचे
जब मैं फुटबॉल खेलती थी तब इंडिया टीम नहीं थी मैं सचिन तेंदुलकर जी को फॉलो करती हूँ उसका जर्सी को फॉलो करती हूँ मुझे इंडिया पहनना है सो बहुत दिन मतलब कुछ नींद भी नहीं आया कुछ भी नहीं आया ऐसे ऐसे फुटबॉल भी इतना अच्छी तरह से खेल रही हूँ और इंडिया नहीं खेलूँगी तो बाद में अपने आप ही कुछ लगेगा सो एक नवोदय विद्यालय में एक सर थी उसका नाम शामसुल हॉक है तो वो सर ने बताया तुम एथलेटिक्स में आओ और एथलेटिक्स में तुम अच्छा कर सकती हो और एथलेटिक्स में आया ढाई सालों में आज से लेकर ढाई सालों पहले एथलेटिक्स शुरू किया था एक साल तो कुछ भी नहीं जानती हूँ बाद में नेक्स्ट एक सालों में मैं इंडिया कैंप ज्वाइन किया तो स्पेशली थैंक्स AFI एथलीट फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडिया उन लोगों ने बुलाया और ट्रेनिंग किया ऐसे.
See, this is see, this story is actually following a curve that was very, very hard in Indian sport at one point. In fact, your coach, Gopi Chand, once drew a triangle for me and explained how sport develops. And he says that he basically said that the pinnacle of the triangle is the elite sportsman, and only that percentage is going to reach on top. But it depends on how large the base is. Because if the base is large, the top of the triangle will also be large.
Yeah.
Do you and Gopi, when you're working out, do you talk about larger things, or is it just focus on game all the time?
I mean, it's just focus on the game because, you know, for me, when I started playing badminton, it was never like long-term goals because it was just step by step, like one step at a time. That's what I feel because for me, it's very important what am I going to play, and at that moment, that's it. You know, focusing on the long-term goals is like, you know, you just forget about what's happening next. And for me, it's always when I discuss it with Gopi sir, you know, it's just that, okay, the next match, or what am I going to do next, or which tournament I'm going to play, that's it. It's not about, you know, what will happen or what's going to happen, because you never know what is going to happen the next day. Where will you be and what will you do?
Do you still start your day at 4 o'clock in the morning?
Now, the timings have changed a bit because if you see now, there are a lot of people who are doing really well and who are coming up. So it starts at 7:30, so quite some time now, not early in the mornings. Yeah.
Okay. In some ways, all your sports require very different skills. Shooting, pistol shooting particularly, is completely different from the aggression required to run or, you know, Sindhu's famous jump smashes. It's actually the opposite. And in his book, Abhinav Bindra sort of articulated several times on how difficult it is to keep yourself still, how to basically get your body to do the opposite of what sport is otherwise supposed to get you to do. So how do you get yourself to that point? What is your method?
In shooting, I think it would be wrong to say that aggression is not there. It's very important to be aggressive, especially when you're in the finals and it's a close call. They're announcing all your scores. You need that aggression. But the only difference is that you can't see it as a spectator. So whatever happens inside us, so you will see a very blank face, but we know the struggle that we are doing inside and pushing ourselves, you know, doing self-talk and motivating ourselves for one shot at a time. What he means by stillness is to be in the present. No matter what your emotion is, you may be scared, you may be aggressive, you may be having a lot of pressure, but you have to be in the present. You can't think of the medal, you can't think of the outcome, you can't think of the result, or similarly, you can't think of a bad shot that you just fired. You know, you have to forget everything and just be in this moment, be with yourself, be one with your sport, and then just keep doing one shot at a time, one breath at a time. That's how I do it.
Hima, jab aap race pe bhag rahe the Finland mein jahan Asian Games mein, to kai baar aisa lag raha tha ki aap thoda piche reh gaye, aur fir ekdam se last 40-50 meters mein sabko piche chhod ke aap ekdam aage nikal jate ho.
Just like Usain Bolt.
Yeah, just like Usain Bolt. So, ye aapka strategy hai, style hai kya hai?
Ye Hima ka style hai. Actually, kya hai pata nahi. So, as a God gift bhi samajhti hu main, kyunki jab se 400 shuru kiya, tab se aisa hi hua hai. 300 तक थोड़ा पीछे नहीं, so equal रहते हैं, क्योंकि जब 400 कार्फ में जब भागते हैं, तो एक स्टार्टिंग यहाँ पे होते हैं और एक वहाँ पे होते हैं, लगते हैं ये वो 390 भागेगी, ये 400 भागेगी, ऐसे लगते हैं, but same ही है, so वहाँ पे कुछ हो जाते हैं, पता नहीं क्या.
एकदम से अंदर से एनर्जी आता है आपको.
एनर्जी या मतलब भागने के टाइम तो कुछ मालूम नहीं चलते, सो ये मैं भी नहीं जानती हूँ कहाँ से आ जाते. इसलिए बोल रहे हिमा का स्टाइल है
लेकिन ये पहले से अलग है. आप पहले 100 मीटर्स 200 मीटर्स भागते थे, उसमें है कि एकदम शुरू से जोर लगाना है और फिर रेस खत्म. अब ये एकदम रिवर्स कर दिया आपने. पहले साथ साथ रहो और एकदम एंड में आगे निकल जाओ.
डेढ़ साल हुआ है मुझे 400 शुरू करने के लिए. पहला एम थी मेरा कोच नवजीत सर एंड निपोन सर दोनों मिलके मुझे बोला था सीनियर टीम में घुसना है. सो सीनियर टीम में घुसने के लिए टाइम भी बहुत कम करना पड़ेगा. तो इन लोगों ने क्या किया, मुझे 400 में घुसाया. 400 में दो चांसेस है, एक है इनविजिबल गेम 400 मीटर और एक है टीम जो रिले भागते हैं. रिले में 6 लोग भाग सकते हैं और 6 में मैं 1, 2, 3 नहीं होंगे तो 4, 5, 6, 2 बनूंगी तो इंडिया टीम में आ जाऊँगी सीनियर में. सो एम तो वही थी. बाद में धीरे धीरे 400 करने शुरू किया. इंडिया कैंप में आया, मिस गेलिना मैम को थैंक यू सो मच, उन्होंने मुझे बहुत अच्छी तरह से सिखाया क्योंकि वो भी खुद ओलंपियन है, ब्रॉन्ज मेडलिस्ट. सो उनका ट्रेनिंग एक सालों में अभी टाइमिंग को अच्छा करने के लिए मैं ऐसे
आपने पिछले कुछ महीनों में अपना टाइमिंग काफ़ी इम्प्रूव किया है, 2 सेकेंड, 3 सेकेंड, 4 सेकेंड. अभी कितना आप आगे जा सकते हैं, आप पीक के पास पहुंच रहे हैं अपने टाइम के कि अभी आगे जाना है आपको बहुत?
हाँ, एक्चुअली मैं कभी भी मेरा मन में नहीं आया मैं मेडल पे पीछे भागू. मैं मेडल में पीछे नहीं भागा आज तक, मैं भागती हूँ टाइम के पीछे. सो मैं हर मैच में सोचती हूँ मेरा अभी 50.79 टाइमिंग है तो मैं कल कैसे करूँगी 50.78 करूँगी. तो 1 माइक्रोसेकेंड के लिए आप लोगों को पता ही है स्प्रिंटर 1 माइक्रोसेकेंड के लिए कितना टफ है. सो मैं भी ट्राई कर रही हूँ मैं कितना हो सके मैं टाइम कम करने के लिए. सो एथलीट ऐसा वाला गेम है, एक टाइम तक ही है, बाद में जितना कोशिश करो नहीं हो पाते. तो मैं चाहती हूँ कम समय में हार्ड प्रैक्टिस करके टाइम कम करने के लिए.
कोई टारगेट रखा है आपने अपने?
नहीं, टारगेट तो ही है बेस्ट टाइमिंग बनाना है.
बेस्ट टाइमिंग. अब सिंधु, बोथ द स्पोर्ट्स देयर इज अ वे टू मेजर हाउ यू डिड टुडे. इन बैडमिंटन द मेजर इज बीटिंग द अदर पर्सन. देयर इज नो वे टू एक्चुअली से दैट यू नो आई विल रीच दिस टाइमिंग और आई विल मेक दिस मार्क. सो हाउ डू यू मेजर इंप्रूवमेंट? इज देयर अ वे टू टेल हाउ यू कैन इंप्रूव, हाउ योर गेम इज बिकमिंग बेटर, एंड डू हाउ डू यू सेट टारगेट्स फॉर योरसेल्फ?
I measure like, you know, every day, I feel every day is a new start. And I go with the motto that, okay, I have to give my 100%, whether if it's in practice or matches. Because, you know, the schedule is so tight that we won't have enough time to practice, actually. So within this, you know, that time, we have to just do whatever we want. And we have to learn from our mistakes. Like, you know, for example, now we lost a match and then again, in 1.5 weeks, we have another tournament. So it is sometimes tough for us because, you know, after losing a match, we feel really bad or we are like depressed, you know, what's happening, what am I playing, or, you know, what's going on. So, you know, to come out from that and again learn from our mistakes and not to do those mistakes again is tough. But it is important that we come out from that as soon as possible and discuss it with our coach. And, you know, we should know that, okay, we are doing this because we play with the same opponent again and again. So, you know, she will know our game and also we will know her game. So it is important that, you know, we need to have 2-3 plans that immediately we need to change our strategy accordingly because everybody has a different style of play. Like, for example, if I'm an attacking, aggressive player, they won't let me attack or they won't let me hit jump smashes, as you said. So it is very important to have plan B and change it accordingly. So for me, it's like, it's just that match. I go into that match thinking that I have to just give my best and just play my game. I mean, the coach is outside sitting there. He might say 1 or 2 points, but it is important that you need to change it as quick as possible. Sometimes you never know. You might be in a leading stage where you actually lose matches or when you're down and you just win matches. So for me, it's just that next point and that rally, like what's going on, and I should get that rally. For me, the match is also not important, but for me, it's just that next point is very important. So I judge myself that way, and I have that short-term, you know, thinking or goals that way. Yeah.
You know, actually, everybody who has written or spoken about you has always talked about your bounce-back ability. that, you know, if you lose, you just pick yourself up much faster than most other players they've known to do. Yeah. But do you feel you're near your peak, close to your peak, already at your peak? You still have a ways to go to reach your peak. Do you feel there is more you can do to develop as a badminton player?
Yes, definitely. You know, as I said, every day is a new start. Like, you know, people ask me that, you've won everything, what else do you want? Yeah. But for me, it's not yet over. This is only the starting for me, and there's more way to go on. You know, like, yeah, as you said, bounce back is another thing where, you know, if I'm down or if I lose matches, immediately in the other matches I win. But it is not so easy for a player to always be at their peak level. I think people should understand that. I mean, expectations are high, responsibilities are always there. Every time I go into the court or I go for a tournament, everybody would expect a medal from me, which is not so easy. And there were also people saying that, you know, you come to the finals, you always lose. What's happening? That shouldn't be there. But rather, I'm very happy that I got a silver. I mean, they should understand that, you know, coming to the finals is one thing and playing the finals is another thing, right? So I'm happy that, okay, you know, I got a silver. But other side, I'm like, definitely I'll get a gold other time, yeah.
Heena, you've been world number one. What are the goals that you're keeping yourself up to? Is there an Olympic dream there? You know, you've done the Commonwealth thing, Asian Games thing. What is it that's keeping you going now?
I think what's keeping me going now, that's a very good question, because I asked myself this few months back. You know, sometimes you have bad training sessions and bad matches and you feel, you know, why am I doing this? Should I take a break, like a long break and restart? Or why am I going on? So I think I'm going on because now I'm in a phase where I'm just trying to discover the game. I'm not here to perform anymore. I'm not here to deliver medals anymore. I asked myself that I started this game because I loved the game. That first day when I picked up the pistol, I wasn't hoping to go to the Olympic Games. I picked it up because I just loved it. I loved the feeling. So I just close my eyes and try to get that feeling back. And every day when you go to the range, if you love what you do, and then the whole process just improves you. You improve with the sport, and the medals come with it. But if you go on, you know, thinking that I'm preparing for this particular medal or this particular performance, of course you can do it. But in the long run, you know, this quest is not going to take you. In the long run, I mean, you can't keep running after a particular medal for 10 years, 12 years, 15 years. You know, you need to grow with the sport. So I'm in that phase where I'm loving my sport and I'm trying to enjoy every day at it.
Thank you. Hima, aapka jo sab aapko follow kar rahe hai, aapke jitne fan hai, wo sab bol rahe hai, ye man joy kya hai? हर बार आप जब जीतते हैं आप बोलते हैं मन जॉय क्या है ये मन जॉय जरा हमको बताइए
मन जॉय एक आसामी वर्ड है बहुत प्यारा सा अच्छा लग रहा है मुझे सो ये मेरा स्टेटस है कभी फ्रेंड्स फॉलोअर्स देखते हैं फेसबुक ट्विटर सब के मन जॉय हिंदी में बोलेंगे तो दिल चाहते हैं उसको और इंग्लिश में बोलेंगे तो एवरीथिंग इज पॉसिबल वो है असमी स्वर मन जाए
तो आप आपको कहाँ से ये वर्ड आपने अपना कैसे बना लिया
मन जाए में मेरा असम में एक सिंगर है दो सिंगर है जिसको हम लोग आइडल मानते हैं डॉक्टर भूपेन हजूरिका और जुबिन गर्ग ये दोनों ने गाना निकल रहा है मन जाए उसमें सुन के बहुत सारा सीखने को मिलते तो उस समय से ये स्टेटस बन गया मन जाए और मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है
तो बनाया गाना उन्होंने लेकिन ले लिया आपने
पॉपुलर तो उन लोगों ही हो रहा है ना अभी
आप जब भी दिखाई देता है ऑफ ट्रेडिंग ग्राउंड में साइड पे हमेशा म्यूजिक कान में हेडफोन्स क्या सुनते हैं आप
कुछ भी मतलब टाइम में सुनती हूँ कभी हिप हॉप लगाती हूँ कभी अच्छा कभी एकदम क्लीन सब तरह गाना सुनती हूँ मतलब जहाँ पे जो गाना चाहिए
आपने जब फिनलैंड में एकदम से मेडल जीता 51 सेकंड्स पहले इंडिया में ज़्यादा लोग को पता नहीं था कौन है हिमा दास 51 सेकंड्स के बाद पूरा इंडिया में आपका फ्रंट पेज पे फोटो छप रहा था आपने घर फ़ोन किया मैंने कहीं पढ़ा है आपने कहानी सुना आपने घर फ़ोन किया पापा को बोलने के लिए कि मेडल जीत गया तो क्या बोला उन्होंने
मेडल जीत के जब रूम में आई पापा को फ़ोन किया बोले हेलो पापा क्या कर रहे हैं पापा ने बोला अभी सोने के लिए रेडी हो रही हूँ तो मैंने बोला मैं वर्ल्ड चैम्पियन बन के अभी सोने के लिए जा रहा है बोला मैंने तो देख लिया तुम्हारा खेल देख के अभी सोने के लिए आई हूँ बोलो ठीक है अभी सो जाओ सुबह पता चलेगा आपको
फिर सुबह क्या हुआ
मेरा पापा भी मतलब ऐसा है वो दिन ISL हुआ था गुवाहाटी में मुझे VIP पास मिला मुझे फैमिली को देखने के लिए पापा ने मुझे बोलते मैंने पापा को बोला पापा चलो मतलब बहुत लोग आए थे मेरा भैया लोग भी आए थे तो उन लोगों ने अलग सा टिकट लेके देखने के लिए गई और मेरे पापा को बोला पापा चलो मुझे बोला तू कुछ कर रहे है तू चल मैं तो किया नहीं मैं यहाँ पे देखूँगी तो ये बात अच्छा लगता है तो और फिर जकार्ता में भी जब गवर्नमेंट ने उसको प्रपोजल दिया था जो आप जाने वहाँ पे जाने के लिए जकार्ता में ने उसका खेल देखने के लिए गवर्नमेंट बोला मैंने सब कुछ करेंगे तो पापा ने बोला नहीं मैं घर में रहूँगी वहाँ पे जाऊँगी तो उसका थोड़ा टेंशन होगा सो मैं घर में रहूँगी मतलब वो पापा मुझे अच्छा लगते ऐसा वाला पापा होना चाहिए सबको
Actually, you know, I mean, all three of you sitting here are women. Gender plays a role at some level or the other in the shaping up of a sportsman. I'll actually come to you, Heena. You grew up with a brother, and I read somewhere that all the attention was on him becoming a sportsperson rather than you. Yeah. Is that correct?
Yes. So when I was growing up, I'm talking about the 90s. The cricket was the only thing, right? So my father always wanted that one of his children should play for the country. So naturally he picked up the boy because cricket is the only thing. So he used to go out, travel, you know, studies was not an option for him. I mean, he used to study, but that was secondary. So I liked his life. And I thought, you know, why not me? Why all the attention to him? So I come from a school where we have all the sports, you know. My school was a very good school. So I tried everything. Can you imagine me playing shot putt? I've done it. So I've gone to every sport that I saw in the school, and I was pathetic at all of them. I was really pathetic. Like, I am actually good at just standing. And I was very smart to pick a sport which requires just standing. So how I picked up shooting was because of my family, because they've got a business in guns. And as a child, I just grew up with a lot of guns in the house. And I loved guns as a child, but never actually thought of shooting as a sport. I was always running after all the other sports, you know, where obvious sport jaisa kuch hona chahiye, where you're running after things or you're fighting against people. So shooting doesn't have all this. So I never looked at it as a sport. So I just started shooting as a hobby because, you know, I was studying medicine and I wanted a little lightness in my day. So I started shooting as a hobby and eventually I just kept winning medals and kept going on and on. So it eventually became a profession.
How does your brother feel about that?
Yeah, now my brother is a student. Like, he's a total geek. a reversal of story. He loves engineering. He loves creating things. So I'm very thankful that my parents actually gave us both a chance to decide for ourselves. Yeah, they put us in different things, but then eventually when we figured out our lives, they just went on with it. So both of us are happy and things have worked out well for both of us.
How did badminton come to you? Why not basketball or volleyball like the family?
Why not shooting?
I used to just play for fun. And then, you know, when my dad used to play volleyball, yeah, my dad is a volleyball player. My mom also was a volleyball player. So besides, there was a badminton court. And, you know, I just started off. And that's how I continued playing. And, well, in our family, there was no boy like you. So I have a sister. So even she used to play, she was into sports. But yeah, in one way, I'm lucky to have parents as sports persons, because you know, they know what it is and they've come from that level. They've faced a lot of things, and they supported me in whichever sport I wanted to, because a lot of people asked, why not volleyball? Because your parents used to play volleyball. But well, I was interested, and that's how I continued playing, and that's how I'm here. Because when I started playing, I never thought, okay, I'll become an Olympic silver medalist. But it was just, okay, let's see what's going to happen. And I think my dad, my mom went through a lot of ups and downs and a lot of sacrifices in life. But they've always supported me, and still, and they've always been motivating me. That's how I am here today. So I'm very thankful to my parents.
Hima, aapka team camp mein kaisa atmosphere rehta hai? Aap log ek dusre ke against race bhi karta hai, saath mein rehta bhi hai, rivalry hota hai, friendship hota hai. Jaise Duti Chand aur aap dono 200 meters pe hai, to kaisa aap log ka relationship rehta hai?
400 camp mein to sabse tang karne wala to main hi hu, kyunki main sabse main chote hu sabse. Aur बहुत प्यार करते हैं भैया लोग और दीदी लोग, बहुत प्यार करते हैं. ऐसा तो अभी आज तक तो कोई झगड़ा वगैरह नहीं लगा, लेकिन बहुत सपोर्ट करते हैं एक ने एक को. अभी 200 में भागूंगी, अकेले अकेले भागते तो एक साथ नहीं भागते. अब रिपीटिशन मारेगा तो मैं अकेले भागूंगी, उसके बाद कोई एक भागेगा. लेकिन जब मैं भागती हूँ या कोई और भागते हैं, मैं उसको सपोर्ट करती हूँ, भागो भागो और चाहिए और खींचो, ऐसे करूँगी. किसी ने ऐसे मतलब फुल सपोर्ट सपोर्ट से एक टीम, मतलब हम लोग प्रैक्टिस करते हैं.
You threw your head back because you knew where I was coming after this. No, actually not. You both have interesting rivals in your careers. Let's just put it that way. Saina was there before you sort of broke out. I read somewhere you said the relationship is high bye. What is it like? What is it? Are you benchmarks for each other? Are you rivals? Is it more intense, less intense? Are you teammates? How do you see each other in what is an individual sport, but you're still playing for the country together from time to time?
Definitely, I think having a rivalry is not bad, I can say, because when you go onto the court, you will have to just win for yourself, and you have to just give your best, and you have to be aggressive. So I would say, you know, rivalry is not bad, but, you know, off court, as you know, definitely, again, it's just high bye. But I mean, you know, we don't play together. I mean, we play in different academies, but we have a lot of people who play with us, and you know, we have a coach. So it's basically like when we play for the country, yeah, we all are together. It's not just that, okay, she's different or I'm different, but when we play for the country, yes. But again, when we play against each other, definitely the rivalry is always there on court, but off court, yeah, we're just normal friends. Yeah.
And your real rivalry actually in some ways is coming from a few different places
these
days, right? So you've got this Japanese thing going.
Japanese, Spain.
And how do you feel about Carolina Marin at the moment?
Yes, I mean, she's a very aggressive player. So when we play against each other, it's, you know, it's going to be a very intense match every time. And yeah, again, with Okuhara is the same way. So it's not so easy, but I think off court, we are very good friends. I think that strong rivalry come a strong friendship, I think it's a good thing.
So you're very good friends with them, but not...
No, I didn't say that. I mean, I said... Yeah, in one way, I think they're very much closer to me than her. Yeah.
They might not be close with the Spanish people, with the Spanish athletes. You know, the story could be the same in Spain and in India.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Maybe, since Carolina is alone, so she might not have any competitor. So, yeah.
Okay. Manu Bakar, go.
Go. Isse puchle. Okay, Heena is next.
No, how does... I mean, in this case, it's a role reversal.
Yes, yes.
So, there's this young person who has come, who you're competing with.
You know what? I told Manu this after the Commonwealth gold that she won when we were backstage. I told her, you remind me of what I was when I was your age. So she's exactly like I was. It's just that the times have changed, like how we started this conversation. You know, the times have changed. So the juniors are getting good coaches, they are getting good exposure. Even the victories are celebrated by the whole country because of the media and the matches being shown on the TV. So things were different when I started shooting. But then people come, you know, like how I entered the shooting arena. Now she's entered the shooting arena. As I told you, she's exactly like me. So it's actually good looking at her. You know, sometimes I can see that how I started and where I've come. And it's sort of like a very, very good, what do I say? It's sort of an invisible connect that I feel with her. But at the same time, I would also like to say that one Mannu Bhakar is not enough. We need more. Because at World Championship, the team didn't do well. We needed a third strong player because the team is of three players. So I would want another Mannu Bhakar.
I'm going to start taking some questions from the audience. First one, Hima, I'm going to ask you. They asked you all, but you answer. Dr. Shalini Khandelwal's question. What is the quality that you have in which you think you can be a world-class sportsman? What
quality
is
it? You guys have all the best.
I've got a question for you, Sindhu, from Riya Gupta, who says, what can make you lose focus on a badminton court? Is there anything that can make you lose focus? And let's answer that first. I'll get to the second point as well.
Okay. I think nothing, because when you go onto the court, it's just you and nothing else. You don't think about anything, basically, because we prepare for that match to give 100%. So I don't think we will just lose focus just like that, because we train for that.
Does it affect you? And this is, I'm just drawing from the second question.
Okay.
If you're playing against an opponent who's very pushy, who's pushing the you know, on the line calls, who's saying, no, this was in, this was out, does that sort of make any difference to you?
See, I think it's everywhere now. Everybody does that, you know. Maybe it's a strategy or it's their way, it's another thing. But you just have to be there and be focused. Like if they push or if they delay the match or if they just say that, you know, you're doing, you know, you're just cheating or you're not giving right calls or going and complaining the umpire or wasting time. I think you have to just be focused. They might disturb you or just do anything. It's a game, so everything is fair, right? So, yeah. I mean, I feel that you shouldn't get disturbed and just be yourself and be focused.
There are some questions, but a lot of them are on a similar theme. One theme that is coming to you, Sindhu, is that you're doing really well, but what is it with finals? Is there a bit of a block that comes in once in a while?
Well, I mean, sometimes I think that, okay, you know, every time, as I said before, every time I go for a tournament, you know, everybody is like, you know, this time you're going to win, this time you will win, we know you will win. I mean, they are already, you know,
they've assumed that it's done.
Yeah, I mean, and, you know, if we don't go up to their expectations, they just become very nervous or they feel bad about what's happening here. But I just want to say that it's not so easy. I mean, we will give 100% from our side because when we go onto the court, we will always want to give 100% and win whichever match we play. But sometimes, you know, it might just not be your day, or sometimes you might play brilliantly. But, you know, sometimes there's a lot of pressure. But, you know, it's just like an ordinary player where you just go and just give your best. And they should understand that from the player's perspective that, you know, they are also giving their 100%. You know, rest is just the game. And on that day, who plays well and give their best is a winner, what I feel.
Aapke liye bhi ek sawal hai. Aap short term mein, daily mein, jab training ke liye jaate ho, aap goal set karte ho apne liye? Ki aaj mujhe aisa karna hai training mein, ye time beat karna hai, ya itna
हम लोग का जो कोच डिसाइड लेते हैं कल क्या करेंगे आज क्या करेंगे लेकिन आज जो किया वो कल जो करेंगे आज नहीं बताएंगे तो वहां पे जाके उधर ही बताएंगे क्योंकि बोलेंगे तो आज हिमा कल ये करूंगे तो माइंड थोड़ा अलग-अलग घूमेगी तो उधर ही डायरेक्ट बोलते हैं तो अच्छा लगता है वहाँ पे करके डायरेक्टली
बोलते हैं अभी ये करो और फिर आप लोग का ट्रेनिंग अलग अलग
मतलब अभी वार्म अप किया नहीं सबको एक ही देते हैं आज वार्म अप किया करके बोलते हैं ये वर्कआउट है ये करना होगा अभी इसी हिसाब से करती हूँ
लेकिन आप रन आपका हर ट्रेनिंग सेशन में रनिंग इन्वॉल्व होता है कि अलग अलग ड्रिल्स करते
हैं अलग अलग ड्रिल्स भी होते हैं सब हर टाइम तो रनिंग ही नहीं एंड्योरेंस बनाने के लिए वो लॉन्ग करना पड़ेगा जिम करना पड़ेगा एंड कभी कभी लॉन्ग रन भी होते हैं कभी फॉरेस्ट में भी होते हैं हिल में भी होते हैं जब और रेस्ट भी चाहिए थोड़ा मसाज वगैरह तो ये तो है ही स्विमिंग भी करना पड़ता है कभी मुझे स्विमिंग नहीं आते है बाकी सब ऐसे ही चलते हैं
तो अब सीख रहे हो आप स्विमिंग की नहीं
नहीं थोड़ा सा जाते हूँ उसके बाद पानी खा के
ओके हीना यू गाइस प्ले यू डू वर्ल्ड कप्स देयर आर शूटिंग इवेंट्स एटसेट्रा व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज इवेंट्स दैट यू डू ऑल द टाइम एंड अ मल्टी डिसिप्लिन इवेंट लाइक अ कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स और द एशियन गेम्स वेयर यू आर पार्ट ऑफ अ कंटिंजेंट
इट्स अ लिटिल डिफरेंट बिकॉज of the amount of attention that we get. One, the pressure of expectations of the whole country, everybody, is more for multidisciplinary events like Olympics and Commonwealth and Asian Games. Even though the other events that we go to, World Cups and World Championships, are much tougher. You know, World Championship is much, much tougher than the Olympic Games for shooting. In Olympics, we've got very limited participation in shooting. Of course, they are the best in the world, but the participation is very limited. In World Championship, we've got players from every country you can think of, and they get their whole contingent. So winning a medal at the World Championship, I would say, is my dream number one, and then would be Olympic Games. Because of the sheer you know, competition that you get at the World Championship. Yes, I think that's the only difference. The difference comes from, I would say, the media, you know. There's more media attention on multidisciplinary events. We want more medals. So it's all the hoopla attached with it. But at the end of the day, you have to do the same thing. You know, you compete against the same people. You meet the same people. So for us, every medal is the same, you know. Games wala is not... I mean, anything special for an athlete, but yes, for a country, it means a lot.
Okay, we're out of time, but one last question, aapse. Ye Usain Bolt ki tarah aap koi sign prepare kar rahe ho, jeetne ke baad karne ke liye? Bolt ka sign jise karte ho?
Nahin, sab ka alag-alag style hai. To, koi jeet ke aise hi chala jaate hai. हम लोग थोड़ा कैमरा आने से थोड़ा ज़्यादा हो जाते हैं तो इसलिए हाँ तो इसलिए सबको एक स्टाइल स्टाइल मेंटेन करना होते हैं तो मैंने भी सीखा वही है मोंजाय मोंजाय मीन्स दिल चाहते जो हाथ ऐसे करके करते हैं
तो अब हम ये देखने वाले हैं आप जब भी जीतोगे तो
दिस लुक्स लाइक भांगड़ा आल्सो
सब कर सकते हैं
या
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Heena Sidhu, PV Sindhu, and Hima Das.